So let's see. Oh, I see, I had put the bookmark on this place as the spot that we want to start from. Did you guys have questions first? Should someone write in this card?
It's too bad, because it's kind of just like, when that cutie ball stuff, you're just kind of planting it there.
Okay, now, I have a suggestion for going forward, since this is higher level. Do you guys want to try to stop using English in class as much as possible and switch over to Japanese 99% of the time? Does that sound like a good idea?
So
obviously, if you've
like
got...
Like, I'm nervous about it.
If you've got questions about grammar, we can break into English. But for just, you know, mainichi kaiwa, we, you know, nihongo de hanashimashou. Ii desu ka? Dekiru to omimasu yo. Yatte mimashou.
Kinchou shite imasu ka?
Ganbatte. Wakaranai toki wa yukkuri itte kudasai to kiite kudasai ne. じゃあ日本語で、68ページから読みましょうね。いいですか？68ページのパートB。ジョーさんとサムさんに。あ、一緒に見てください。じゃあ、A とB の例え。
頭から痛いんです。じゃあ、家に帰ったらどうですか？いいですか？わかりますか？じゃあ、サムさんとエリさん、一番お願いします。美味しいケーキが食べたいんです。痩せたらどうですか？痩せたらどうですか？
おいしいケーキが食べたいと言ってますね。だから、私、おいしいケーキが食べたいんです。例えば、じゃあ、パン屋さんに行ってみたらどうですか？パン屋さん、わかりますか？はい。パン屋さんは、だいたいケーキもあります。 普通の日本の家はオーブンがないんです。わかりますか？オーブン、ケーキを作るところ、ストーブがありますけど、オーブンがないんです。だから日本人は大抵パン屋さんに行ってパンとケーキを、
普通の家はオーブンがないんですから。じゃあ2番、エリさんとセス君。薄いカメラが欲しいんです。うん。じゃあ コダックのカメラを買ったら、 but I want to say,
あの、しか。先生。はい。学生と先生。カード。はい、はい、ありがとう。
あ、あった。じゃあ、先生やった。じゃあ、ジョーさんは先生にいますね。
あ、すごい。
はい。はい。はい。
That's good.
はい、ありがとう。忘れちゃった。たらどうですかって、わかりますか？
Yeah, okay. I wasn't aware of it.
Verb, たらどうですか？ Short form past.
Yeah, I was going to say, it would be better for you not to buy that kind of camera, but we're not learning negative form of advice giving, so.
今は positive だけですね。
Yeah, so it's okay.
でも、カメラが好きですか？
はい、
好き
だ。でも、安いカメラが欲しいんですから、例えば、秋葉原、わかりますか？秋葉原。聞いたことありますか？秋葉原は、電子製品とかカメラとかコンピューターとか売るところです。東京の一部分は秋葉原。東京の一つのところ。
一部分。
これ東京ですね。東京。はい。ここは。というところです。わかりますか？一部分。これは全部で、これは一部分。わかりますか？全部、一部分、二部分、三部分。わかりますか？ One part。一部分。いいですか？一つのパート。一部分。ごめんね。私はドローインが下手です。じゃあ、秋葉原はカメラとかコンピューターとか、ビデオカメラとか、iPad とか、
アニメものとか。
アニメじゃない。電子のもの、電子。電子製品って、electronics、電子。わかりますか？
電子。
電子。電気。
電子。
携帯電話。これ。携帯電話。これ携帯電話。コンピューター、カメラ、そういうものを。安く売ってるところです。わかりますか？安いカメラが欲しいとき、日本人は秋葉原に行きます。
英語話してもいいですか？
はい。
Isn't Akihabara like the place where they all the like otaku stuff is?
You're thinking of Harajuku.
Is it?
はい。
So all the electronic stuff is in
Akihabara. 秋葉原。秋葉原、はい、だから安いカメラが欲しい時は秋葉原に行った方がいいかもしれない。
はい。Yeah. じゃあ安いカメラ、秋葉原に、
はい、じゃあ
安いカメラを
買
った、買ったら
ど
うですか？
はい、秋葉原で安いカメラを買った方が、買ったらどうですか？はい、はい、いいですか？わかりますか？はい、じゃあ、サス君とジョーさん、3番やってみてください。
ちょっと負担です。
太ったんです。
太ったんです。
本当？見えないね。
じゃあ、運動したらどうですか？
はい、運動したらどうですか？運動したらいいですね。
Is there a way to do that? Like, sensei to 学生、is there a way to do that?
ああ、運動したらどう？
どう？です、どう？
はい。運動したら、
That works.
Nice.
Kono goro tsukarete iru desu.
Hai, tsukarete iru, iru no desu. Or tsukarete iru da. Mijikai bai wa, sensei ga yuu bai wa, kono goro tsukarete iru da.
Tsukarete iru da.
Nettara dou desu ka?
はい、いいですね。もっと寝た方がいいですね。寝たらどうですか？あ、そうですね。ありがとう。クラス中寝たらダメです。勉強が大嫌いなんです。
いいですね。よく寝られないんだ。寝られないはわかりません。あ、寝る？わかる？寝る。あ。
寝る。寝られない。寝たいけど寝られない。ね。カモミールティー飲むとか何がいいかな。コーヒー？コーヒー飲まない方がいい。いや。コーヒー。 カモミールティーわかる？熱い牛乳。ちょっと待って。牛乳は温かい。好きじゃない。ああ、そっか。薬。あ、そうですね。じゃあコーヒーを。
やめる? Conjugation.
やめたら? これは, it needs to be a positive conjugation, not a negative. So, コーヒーをやめる, to quit drinking coffee. コーヒーをやめた方がいい。
Okay, what is doyo yumi?
Neranai, unable to sleep.
Yoku often, right?
Yeah, or can't sleep well.
Oh, insomnia.
Yeah, hi, insomnia. だから例えば カモミール ティーとか.
Yeah, I was getting confused over that.
カモミールティーを飲んだらどうですか？飲んだ、いやいや、それは私が、I was asking
conjugation for
飲む、飲んだら、飲んだら、じゃあどうぞ。
やめたら、どうですか？やめる、クイット。やめたらどうですか？コーヒーを全然コーヒーを飲まない。あ、そっか。じゃあカモミールティーはどう？
カモミールティー。問題ある。はい。カモミールティー。
料理、お茶の方。
カフェイン。
カフェイン。
はい、カフェインがあるでしょ。
大変ですね。
全部、全部カフェインのやめたら
あ
どうですか。
はい、そうですね。カフェインを全部やめたらどうですか。そうですね。じゃあ、セス君とジョーさん、7番。
友達ができないんです。
サークルに入ったら、
はい、サークルに入ったら、サークル、わかりますか、サークル。わかるね。
このレッスンの単語。
前の単語でしょ。前のレッスンの単語。サークルって、友達と一緒にグループ作って好きなことをする。ということ。サークルって。英語でクラブという。
クラブ。
大学のクラブとかはサークルという。はい。あった？あ、サークルに入る。はい。はい、あった、あった。
いい考えで。
はい。いい考えですね。はい。じゃあ、8番、ジョーさんとサンドルさん。
金がないんです。
金がないんだ。
アルバイトを。アルバイトをしたらどうですか？
大変ですね、先生。先生もやってる。アルバイトもやってる。忙しいね。はい、じゃあ、サン
デ
さんとエリーさん、
感情が、ケチで何もくれないんです。
なったらどうですか。
はい、
なったらどうですか。
なったら、な、泣いたら。
あ、泣いたらどうですか。
そっか。おかしい。彼女の前で泣いたらプレゼントをあげるかもしれない。面白い。じゃあパート C やってみましょう。じゃあまず、あ、 A と B と C があるね。だからじゃあエリーさん A、 セス君 B、 ゾウさん C、 お願いします。読んでみましょう。そしてまた、
日本人の友達が欲しいんですが、できないんです。どうしたらいいですか。
そうですか。じゃあサークルに入ったらどうですか。
忙しいから、サークルはちょっと。
じゃあ日本語の先生に。
それはどう
さん。あ、必死。
じゃあ日本語の先生に相談
し、
どうですか。
わかりました。そうします。ありがとうございます。
はい、いいですね。じゃあみんな一人ずつ A のパートをやって、そして他の学生たちはアドバイスをあげましょう。わかる？じゃあ、セス君、自分の問題を言ってください。何でもいいですから。フィクションでもいいです。
日本語のクラスは難しい。難しいんです。
はい。そしてどうしたらいいですか。どうしたら。
あ、どうしたらいいんですか。
そうね。
そうですか。じゃあ、みんなで勉強したらどうですか。
みんなはちょっと。
したいんですか？
みんなと一緒に勉強する。I have absolutely no idea what I'm talking about anymore.
I want to
say, kinshoして, I didn't know how to use it with that sentence.
So you're responding to his suggestion, right? He made the suggestion, what if you study with the group? Sesu-kun wa, tatoeba, hitori de benkyou suru no ga suki datte. Ne? Hitori de benkyou shita hou ga suki desu. To itte mashita ne.
Hai.
Dakara, the idea of the exercise is to kind of like protest the first suggestion. And then other people come up with other ideas for you, so you could say something like "hitori de benkyou shita hou ga suki desu." Wakaru?
I can't think of a way to respond to that without being rude. Ja, hitori de nihongo o benkyou shita ra dou desu ka?
もっと練習したらどうですか？ That would be another way to put that. そして、So you want to respond to his suggestion before Ellie tries to come up with another idea?
I'm not really sure if I have a response.
Okay, so for example, you could say, アルバイトで忙しいですから時間がないんです。Because the idea is you're like, every time they give you a suggestion, you're protesting that, but that won't work because. That's kind of the idea of the exercise, to practice.
Be picky and stingy.
It's practicing making suggestions, and practicing accepting or rejecting suggestions, but the whole exercise ends if you accept the suggestion. So the idea is to wait until the last suggestion before you accept it so that you get more practice in making your classmates come up with ideas.
Okay. Sorry, I'm just moving a little slow.
Just make excuses.
So yeah, it's kind of like the learn how to make excuses in Japanese. Activity.
日本語のクラスは難しいと言ってますか？
はい。日本語のクラスが難しいと言ってますね。じゃあ他にアドバイスがありますか？
漢字を練習したらどうですか？
漢字を練習したらどうですか？
私は手伝います。
あ、そうですか。
ありがとう。
親切ですね。
そうします。
はい、いいですね。はい、それから例えば他のアドバイスは、例えばもっと日本語を聞いたらどうですか。あるいはヘロトークで日本語を、人の友達を作ったらどうですか？
メッセージを送ったらどうですか？
はい。わかりますか？ So there's lots of different suggestions you can come up with. You're just not used to having to think them up in Japanese freehand like this without
the
book's suggestions, right? So, もっと練習しましょうね。じゃあ、ジョーさんの問題は何でしょう。
ゃあみんなでピザのレストランに食べに行ったらどうですか？
ピザが好きじゃないから嘘
ピザはダメか。
どうしたんですか？忘れてます。
チーズのアレルギーだね。
そう。
残念。
じゃあまた他のアドバイスはどう？ピザのレストランはダメだってどうしますか？
もう一度。
彼はピザはどう？ピザを食べたらどうって言って、ジョーさんはピザはダメって言ってますね。だからエリさんのアドバイスは、お腹空いてる。お腹が空いた。
日本料理を食べたらどうですか？
Is there a term for just like eating out at a place?
Restaurant で食べる。
日本のレストランとは大学生の近いです。
大学の隣に日本のレストランがありますか？
はい。
大学の近くにありますね。近く。隣じゃない。でも近い。でしょ？Fujiyama? Is that what you're thinking of?
No, I was just making it up.
Oh.
I was just saying,
Fujiyama
go eat. I was trying to say, go eat Japanese food because there's a restaurant by the college.
Ah, okay. You're giving him advice. He's still complaining that he's hungry. Yeah, he's rejected pizza and Japanese food.
Jo-san じゃない。
そう、これはフィクションだね。フィクション。本当じゃないよ。
卵を食べたらどうですか？
食べない
。いいね。ハンバーガー好きですか？この人はは
い、じゃあハンバーグを食べたらどう？
食べましょう。
はい、いいですね。はい、わかりましたか？じゃあサンヌンさんはどんな問題がありますか？
頭が痛いんです。
大変ですね。
どうしたらいいですか？
薬を飲んだらどうですか？
薬はちょっと大嫌いですか？
残念ですね。
What was your system?
ベッドなったらどうですか?
ベッドがないから
ベッドがない かわいそうに ホームレス ベッドがないから それもダメなんで ゾウさんのアドバイスは?
家もない
I don't know the verb, but to take off, like...
Ah, 帽子を... Kaburu is to put on. Nuku is to take, like, shoes and socks off, but I'm not sure if it works for hats.
Yeah.
帽子を取る. I think you use 取る to take off a hat.
So...
帽子を取った.
Like, does 取り or 取?
取ったら.
取ったら. So, 帽子を取ったら. That's good.
取ったらどう?取ったらどう?ちょっと髪が嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?嫌い?
から。
先生に。
あ、いいえ。彼女に頼んで。
ああ、そう。
そう。頭が痛いんだら、痛いなら、マッサージはいいかもしれない。
いいですね。
じゃあ、エリさん、問題は何でしょう？
教科書はしまえないんです。
大変ですね。
明日どうですか？あ、アメどうしたらいいですか？
いいです。
音楽を聴いたらどうですか？
音楽
ちょっとなぜ
じゃあ賛成
みんな日本語を教えたらど
う？もう一度
みんなに日本語を教えたら
教える教えます、うん、to teach
は
い、教えたらどう？もっと面白いか
ちょっと
教えたくないさあ、サンさんはいいアドバイスがある
新しい教科書を買ったら、
買ったら
どうですか？
ちょっと、
良くない？どうしよう。違う教科書を使ったらどう？
使う。新しい教科書。
はい、違う教科書、different book。使ったらどう？どうですか？面白いですか？こういう練習がいいですか？
いい。
難しいでしょうね。
難しい。
でも、いい練習になるでしょう。
はい。
はい。じゃあ、パート5。A と B をスキップしますか？
はい。
いい？じゃあまず例を読んでみましょう。例わかりますか？例は example という意味です。例。例。example。違う感じです。だから例を読みましょう。じゃあ一つの例はあのエリさんとシャス君 A と B。
ものを何冊持っていますか。
いつ持つ？一冊
持
っています。
一冊か
しか。
一冊しか持っていないんですか？
興味がありませんから。
はい。興味がありませんから。
質問がある。
はい。
What's the difference between A and A?
え小さい字。
え、oh,
びっくりしました。
Okay.
一冊持っています。一冊しか持っていないの？変な人びっくりした。わかる？わかる？じゃあ、ジョーさんとサンヌンさん、次の例を読んでみましょう。
漫画を何冊持っていますか？
100冊ぐらい持っています。
何冊を持っているんですか？
日本の漫画が大好きですから。
はい。面白いですね。100冊もびっくりしますね。
当然ですね。
じゃあ、皆さん分かりましたか？
うん。
じゃあ、こういう質問に答えてみてみましょうね。じゃあ一番、じゃあエリさん一番を聞いて、セス君と会話しましょう。
今いくら持ってる？
いくらはどういう意味？
いくら How many？
Yeah, what? I don't know what I'm supposed to say.
How much did you bring?
Let's pick something you want to ask. How many of something does he have?いくら持っていますか？
犬はいくら持っている？持っている？
ぬいぐるみの犬。ぬいぐるみの犬。Stuffed animals. Because 持っている you wouldn't use for living animals.
ぬいぐるみの犬。いくら持っている？
ぬいぐるみの犬。わかる？
Could you use that for living things if you're being rude?
It sounds weird.
Okay.
Cow is the verb for raising pets. So it would be like, 犬いくら It wouldn't even be いくら It would be 何匹飼っていますか? How many?
Okay.
You know, 匹 is the measure word for small animals.
Okay, so let me give us, let me get this straight. Am I answering how many stuffed animal dogs I have?
Anata no ryōshin, kodomo no toki, anata no ryōshin wa nuigurumi o kaimashita ka?
Ah, katte agemashita ka?
Hai. Ima nuigurumi no imi wa ikura motteiru.
Ah, naruhodo. Kodomo no toki, nuigurumi atta desho?
Well, I know what I want to say, but I don't think I know the word for this, so I'll go for the number. Inu no noigurumi, is that?
Inu no noigurumi.
Tashi no kodomo no toki. The counter for this?
Yeah, I think it would be noigurumi no inu.
Noigurumi no inu.
Yeah, stuffed animal dog. Not a dog's stuffed animal. Because the other way around sounds like it's a stuffed animal that belongs to the dog.
Hi. Watashi no inu.
ぬいぐるみが持っている。持っている。そうね。だからぬいぐるみの犬 would be a stuffed animal dog. Okay, so am I using the same counter for animals that I'm using for?
You would use like hitotsu futatsu probably. Do you remember the Japanese numbers? Hitotsu futatsu mitsu.
Yeah. So what's the word for counter? I just use hiki?
Hiki sounds like it's for a living animal. So
you
again,
ko?
I would ko or hitotsu futatsu mitsu without a counter. You don't need a counter if you're using the Japanese numbers that end in tsu. Hitotsu motteimasu. You don't need a counter if you're using those numbers. You only need it if you're using this final Japanese.
Yeah. Roku no counter at wasureteta.
Okay. So roku would be mutsu.
Mutsu?
Hai. Mutsu is the equivalent of roku.
So kodomo no toki nuigurumi no to inu or inu no?
Nuigurumi no
inu. Nuigurumi no inu. Wa.
Hai.
I'm getting kind of confused by their use of O and...
Just do it the best you can and I'll help you if it's fixing. For example, what are you trying to say, and I can help?
I'm just trying to figure out how this fits in with this the structure that they're giving us with the mo and shika. I don't really know.
Okay.
Okay, so why is it that...
She's asking you how many you have now. So I thought... What I thought you were going to do was say that you used to have
number... She asked me how many I had in my childhood, right? Or no?
Well, she was saying you used to have them when you were a kid. How many do you still have, right?
I first asked, did your parents buy you stuffed animals when you were a kid?
Right.
And then I asked, how many stuffed animal dogs do you have?
Yeah, is what you meant now for
yeah.
that part, right?
Yeah.
So, 今, いくつ持ってますか?
I'm sorry if that was a hard question.
yeah.
None.
Okay.
So I can't follow. That's why
okay.
I don't want to answer that question. Because,
ありません.
Yeah,
yeah.
全然ありません, but
okay, but if you wanted
I
want to...
I'm trying to figure out the structure the
okay.
way you're asking.
So if you're talking about childhood, do you feel like the number that you used to have was a lot or not very many?
I wanted to say as many as six.
Okay. So, 6 つもありました.
6つもありました?
はい, would be, I had 6, and I think that was a lot. Okay? 6つしかありませんでした would be, I only had 6, and I wished I had a lot more. Do you see what I'm saying? The same exact number, you can use it with either one, depending on whether you feel like that was a lot or a little.
Okay, but what particle is going between the noun and the number here?
Nothing.
Nothing?
Yeah. Mutsu mo, well, mo or shita, that's the only particle you need right now. Mutsu mo arimashita, I had as many as 6. Or mutsu shika arimasen deshita, I didn't have more than 6. I only had 6. Poor baby. do you get what I'm doing?
Somewhat, I guess.
Okay. So, well, 1 is a confusing question. いくら持っていますか? I guess maybe what they were trying to do is just have you kind of be giving a generic answer.
I have this many.
How many of some unmentioned object do you have? It's kind of a weird way to start off the exercise because
yeah.
they're not specifying an item for you to be talking about.
I guess it's trying to get you to memorize the counters.
Yeah, so, 今いくら持っていますか? So how many do you have right now? It sounds like, you know, maybe some of them got left at home, but you have some of them with you, of whatever it is, you know.
It's out of context.
Yeah, it's very much out of context. So how about we switch it over to pens, okay? Pen は今いくら持っていますか? How many pens do you have on you?
So, shika is only.
Yeah, shika is only.
So, I wanted to say, okay. Watashi wa pen o. They're using o here in between.
Okay.
Like, I don't know why, but they are.
So you
forgot. O isatsu shika motte imasen.
Okay,
yeah,
pen o ippon shika motte imasen.
Ippon?
Yeah, ippon would be the measure word for pen.
Okay, so let's...
Because it's a long...
Because it's a long skinny thing. Ippon.
No.
What do you use for snake?
That's hiki.
I would assume hiki because it's a living thing.
What if it's a really big snake?
Like a,
yeah.
I thought it was like a, there was a weird one, like ippiki or something.
Well, ippiki is the pronunciation shift on
ippiki.
Ippiki, nihiki, sambiki,
I know the rules for that, I'm not really sure. But ippon for pen, why? I would use ko.
Well, hon.
Is that...
Hon is the measure word for long, skinny things.
Okay, so what is the generic counter call being used for the most part?
The generic counter, it can be used either when you just don't know what the proper counter is, so you're just substituting call as like a stopgap until you learn the right one.
It becomes go and with one.
No, call doesn't change. Iko, niko, sanko. It doesn't change pronunciation. but so ko is the one that you can use for when you don't know the measure word, and it can also be used for small items that don't fit any of the other categories. So like for example, small round things tend to take ko. So like ringo, apples, ikko, niko, sanko.
Yaki
no boru.
Yakyu
no ball. Yeah,
that's the three.
also, like, kagi, keys. Ikkon, niko, sanko. But if you're talking about something that does have a commonly known measure word, then you would normally use that one.
Saki was kage.
Kai?
Ki? Kage?
Kagi. Kagi.
Kagi.
Kagi is a key.
Kagi.
Kage.
Kage? Kage. Is that something else?
Wind. Maybe.
No, it's kaze.
Kaze,
sorry.
Kaze is
kage,
wind.
Kage.
Kage.
Shadow?
Shadow.
Yeah,
Kage.
Yeah,
Kage.
I think so.
Kage.
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 Kage
no
bunchi.
Kage.
Yeah.
Notice it's got the kin radical because it's usually made out of metal.
Yeah, I was just checking the kanji.
Okay, so tell me what you're trying to get to and I'll help you put it together. So you're trying to say you just have one pen, or what?
Yeah, I mean, that's what they say to do, just to use, they use it for the Japanese dictionary example in the book.
Okay, so yeah, so...
Nihon no jisho.
Nihon no jisho wa issatsu shika...
Jisho, issatsu shika motte imasen. That's what they say.
Jisho wa issatsu shika motte imasen. Blank
wo
motte imasu.
Motte, that's why it's before.
But it's after the noun, not after the number.
Yeah.
It's never after the number.
Yeah. So that would be, Atashwa pen.
Pen.
Pen no I.
Pen
ippon,
o ippon.
Ippon.
Shika. Motte imasen.
Motte imasen.
Hai. Ippon. Ippon. Shika. Motte imasen. Hai.
Pen no.
Pen no.
Hi.
Do you remember like the exercise where we did like the ordering food?
Nani?
Like hamburger or hitotsu kudasai, things like that. That's the same structure.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. I'm not questioning. I just thought you were telling me to say wa the whole time.
Oh.
That's what I was saying before, and then you were like, yeah. So
okay,
I was confused.
Sorry. Sometimes wa substitutes in weird places, so I hadn't remembered that this book was teaching you to use O there, so I wasn't thinking about it that way. 私は日本語の辞書を一冊しか持っていません。いや、この会社にはパソコンが2台しかありません。大変。2台しかないの。
Wait, so when is it が?
Yeah, future.
It's based on the verb.If you took the number phrase out completely, what particle would go between that noun and that verb? So, computer ga arimasu, because it's arimasu, right? Hon o motte imasu, because it's motte imasu.
Okay, yeah, I see. Yep, so here, their example, they use imasu. There are cats in our house, so...
Yeah, neko ga imasu.
Yeah, so it
would
have to be ga.
Okay,
yeah.
So is that where the confusion was? You didn't know how to figure out what particle to put there. Okay, now you know. So if you take the number phrase out and the ska or the mo out, the particle that goes with the noun is the one that would be appropriate for that noun with that verb. So, Tokyo ni ikimashita. Tokyo... You know, if you're saying that, you know, you only went to one town. Machi ni hitotsu shika ikimasen deshita. As far as going to towns, I only went to the one. You know, if you were talking about, you know, like having gone sightseeing in some other country or whatever.
Mm.
Yeah, you just spent the whole time sightseeing in the one town. You know. Does that make sense? じゃあ、OK、2番の質問を聞いてください。いい?
昨日か、何時勉強しましたか?
何時間
勉強?何時間勉強しましたか?
昨日1時間も勉強しました。
しました。
しました。
も、OK、1時間も勉強しました。So you feel like 1 hour was a lot of studying.
By quantity, not quality.
Ah.
I can't
Okay. But that's kind of part of the point of this exercise, is that regardless of what number you're saying, you can give your impression of whether that's a lot or a little just by whether you use the mo and the positive or Scott and the negative.
So throw
in that same sentence.
Chicago after the G-Con would be like, oh, I've only studied for like an hour,
yeah,
it's not much.
Yeah, Ishi G-Con Scott, Benkyo Shimasen Deshita would be, I only studied for an hour, it wasn't that long. Ichi jikan mo benkyou shimashita is like, I normally only spend 5 minutes on this stuff, and this time I spent a whole hour. You know, do you see what I'm saying? It really puts a completely different connotation on what without that would be just a factual statement. Ichi jikan benkyou shimashita is to study for an hour, no emotional context, right? Ichi jikan mo benkyou shimashita, I studied for a whole hour. Or, 1時間しか勉強しませんでした. I only studied for an hour, that's hardly anything. You know, but you see what it does?
Is that the only connotation it can give, or can it be like the way he said it, like, I studied for an hour, and to me that's good because I got an hour of quality studying, and is it just like...
Well, it's saying that to you it feels like a lot versus a little.
Specifically, it feels like a lot.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it's not necessarily addressing quality, it's addressing quantity. That to you, that seems like a lot.
Okay.
You know, so if you've got a manga collection, for example, and, you know, you say, Hakusatsu shika motte imasen, you only have 100 manga, because, you know, your best friend has 1,000, so you feel like 100 is nothing. You know?
That's a lot.
Versus somebody else thinks, you have 100 manga? That's ridiculous. That's so many. You know, so it depends on your perspective, right? If you're a complete manga otaku, then maybe, you know, 100冊しか持ってません. Right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay, and we've got your problem figured out, right?
Mm-hmm.
Would it completely defeat the purpose if I said Takusan?
Yes, it would.
Just like the he told Sufutatsu?
Hi.
Okay.
Or hon. Hon is the measure word they're using.
Okay. Would it be Ega or Futotsu?
Futatsu.
Bon.
No, either Futatsu or Nihon.
Nihon.
Nihon or Futatsu, one or the other.
Oh. Futatsu.
Futatsu shika mimasen or futatsu mo mimasu. You have to pick.
Futatsu mo mimasu.
Hai, futatsu mo mimasu. So to you, watching 2 movies in a month feels like a lot. Mm.
Okay. Uso.
Okay, but we're actually missing the whole point of the exercise. I just realized if you look at the examples. Futatsu mimasu. And then he's supposed to say, Futatsu shika motemasu
ka? I think we should do that just so I can be surprised.
So let's try to do it according to that structure. So you say futatsu mimasu.
Futatsu mimasu.
And then Joe-san has to decide whether he thinks futatsu is a lot or a little.
Futatsu mo motte.
Futatsu mo mimasu ka?
Futatsu mo mimasu ka.
So, wow, you see 2 movies every month? That's a lot.
We don't get that much.
Kai desu ne. Wakarimasu ka? So that's the point that we were missing. we got so bogged down in how to ask the question and how to answer the question. So let's keep going and see if we can get better at this. Okay, so you're answering why you only see two movies in a month.
Mm.
That would be if he said, "Futatsuska mimasen ka?" But if he's saying, you see two every month? That's a lot. Then you would say something like, "Hai." Do you understand the difference?
Yeah.
So on the one hand, if somebody thinks, wow, you don't do that very much, or you don't have a lot of that, you have an explanation for why you only have that small amount, because they're expensive or whatever. If somebody thinks that's a lot of that thing, then you have to have an explanation for why you do it that much. Like, it's your favorite thing or whatever.
Ichiban, how do you say, like, favorite thing to do?
Ichiban
suki na koto. Suki na koto?
Yeah.
Oh, that's just thing.
Koto is a thing
koto
that osu. Is an event.
Oh, okay.
Versus mono, which is an
oh,
object.
Oh, that's right. You're right.
Yeah. So, ichiban suki na koto desu kara. It's my favorite kind of event.
Is daisuki koto?
Daisuki na koto means it's the very best thing that he likes.
Daisuki
na koto would be like, it's one of my favorites. Okay, daisuki is I like it a whole lot. Ichiban suki is I like it more than anything else. Ichiban is the first.
Yeah, I was about
most.
To ask you about that. It's like, would you use that if that was like your number one favorite? I guess they would specify that, wouldn't
yeah,
they?
You can. Ichiban suki na koto. Or daisuki no koto da. Dakara. Yeah.
So omae ni shishimon ga arimasu.
Hai.
Would you use like I know mou sugi when you're saying too much of something, but how many could you say too many? Like in response to that, like for example, how many movies in 1 month?
Yeah.
Would you say too many? I mean, I know we're trying to do counter words, but that was like a real answer.
I mean, you could say taksan meter, a lot of them, but
too I don't many, like all, like as if saying that it's bad for your health or something like that.
I was like,
oh,
response.
Like misugi.
It's like, oh, I say like 30 movies a week. It's like that's way too many.
Yeah.
Kind of compound.
Yeah, misugi would be like watching too much. You know, like overdoing it.
Okay.
So if you asked eigo wa ikagetsu ni eigo wo nanbon kurai mimasu ka, and he said ikagetsu ni 40 bon kurai mimasu, then you could say nihongo 40 bon wo mimasu ka, misugi desu ne. That's like overwatching. 40 in 1 month is twice in some days. You know.
Two is too many.
Right.
Misugi.
Miru.
Misugi.
Misugi.
Misugiteiru.
Misugiteiru. Yeah, you're overwatching. Misugiteru. That's too much watching. Right. Ja, tsugi, Sanon-san to Eri-san, yatte mimashou ka.
今学期、授業をいくつとっていますか?
What's the count of your classes?
Ah,授業をいくつとっていますか?
Cool.
No, that's smaller objects.
Yeah, that's not. 授業を1つ2つ I would go with 1つ2つ. 1つ2つ3つ4つ like that, because ko generally means small physical objects.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay.
So it's a little odd to
it's
mix
their fault
it.
For saying generic.
Yeah.
So, 今学期授業を4つも取っていますか？あ、取っています。
あ、4つ取っています。はい。Okay, so now you have to decide whether you think that's a lot or a little. 4つ取っています。So, you're supposed to decide whether you think 4つ is a lot or a little.
Oh.
And you answer with either ska or mo.
I spaced out.
Yes, you did.
4つ。
1つ2つ3つ4つ。
4つも申します。
4つも取っていますか。
So
yeah, he's saying, wow, you're taking 4 classes, that's a lot. So that's a very stereotypical American answer.
What's the word for humble?
Humble じゃない. Or you could answer with something like 忙しいですから or 今学期卒業したいんですから
たくさん授業が好きですから
okay. Or 今学期卒業したいんだから卒業したい I want to graduate.
Oh.
Yeah, so you're trying to finish it up. Hi. 質問?
Yes, remind me, because I've heard you guys say it a couple times now, obviously, but I wasn't really sure what it meant. Saboru? What is
saboru?
Is that there,
class. To skip class.
Oh.
Yeah, saboru is, it's from...
okay.
The basic meaning of saboru is to sabotage. But saboru...
I don't know why I forgot that one, since you gave that like very interesting
story.
Comparison.
Yeah, saboru is to sabotage. So, jugyo saboru means to skip class, to cut class. It doesn't necessarily specify, but it sort of has a connotation of illegitimate absence, like you had no business skipping class that day, you didn't have a real reason to be gone, you just skipped, you know, as opposed to 授業を休む, which is to take a break from class, which has more of an implication of, you know, maybe you were sick, maybe you had 用事, you know, but you had a reason. But you had a legitimate reason that the sensei would accept, as opposed to 授業をサボった, which is more like you were, you know, out behind the trailers smoking something not quite legal. It's legal in some states, but... kind of got that connotation to it, though. Saboru.
that extreme?
Not always, but sometimes. In Japan, it's still illegal, so... But even, like, tobacco is not legal for high school kids in Japan, either. It's like, it's not legal for most high school students here. It's like 18, so... Jugo Saboru could be, you know, for a high school class, could be out back smoking a cigarette. It implies illegitimate reason for being out. Mm-hmm. Okay, so moving on.
Kongaki, jugyo, o nankai saborimashita ka?
Kongaki.
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 Yeah, this semester.
This hai. Semester, hi. Kongaki. Saying desu sounds weird there. Yeah, iigakusei desu ne is like, wow, you're a good student. Iigakusei desu ka?
I don't know,
like,
actually,
are you a
I
good
think,
student?
I think it's a fair question. Because I think it's very clear that no. Punctuality, my Achilles heel. But that's all I've got going for me. It's...
But for the sake of this exercise, you could say
yeah.
a number.
Last semester would be.
Sengaki.
Sengaki.
Jitsu wa sengaki.
Sankai.
It would be sabori mo.
Sabori mashita. Jugyo o sankai sabori mashita. And then she's the one who's supposed to use the shika or the mo.
Oh, okay.
Jugyo o sankai mo sabori mashita ka?
So she's saying, wow, that was a lot, three times.
Good.
And then you would say,
Doshite sankai?
Come up with some reason.
Sengaki. Kurasu wa tsumaranai desu.
Tsumaranakatta desu.
Tsumaranakatta desu.
Hai. Okay. Ja, shitsumon ga arimasu ka? Any questions? We're out of time, so we're going to stop there, but we can try to finish those last couple next time if you guys want to.
And yeah,
then
I
want to
practice
on.
The next time.
Yes. Okay.
And then
might be good OPI topics, so think about, you know, maybe coming in prepared to talk about those makumeno nenshu topics.
Well, it seems like a lot of it's set up for us to, like, have easy OPI, like, subjects, because they go back and forth a bunch.
Yeah.
Too much difficulty in coming up with sentences because the sentences I would come up with in English are not really standard. That's probably the issue.
I guess
the problem is, like, I want, like...
You want to just have a free-flowing conversation without restrictions, but the textbook...
The barriers of, like, where I am and, like, where the textbook is at, where, like, what it wants me to answer with is, like, not really...
Yeah, the textbook
is
set up for you to practice this particular grammar structure within the context of that exercise, and you're thinking in terms of oh, I want to say this, but it doesn't necessarily fit the grammar structure they want you to practice.
Yeah, but I found, like, you know, when I'm studying in private and I look up ways to say certain things that I don't really know how to say in context, like, I find that to be a much more interesting learning experience than just binding myself to the rules of,
right,
like, because most of the time you're not really, I mean, I don't know, like...
Yeah, well, and that method works great if you're doing one-on-one study. Doesn't work so great for a group setting because everybody, you know, prepared those particular exercises, or at least I hope they did. So, you know, if we don't have anything prepared as a curriculum, then, you know, yeah, we might be able to have a nice free-flowing discussion, but it ends up being the things that people already know how to say instead of the things that we're trying to learn how to say. You see what I'm saying? You know, that format works great for, like, conversation club, kind of, where you just come in and maybe somebody's picked the topic for discussion and you just talk about it in whatever language you know how to use, and if you get stuck and don't know how to say something, somebody either teaches it to you or you look it up and figure out how to say it for the sake of continuing that conversation in that setting. But I can't run a class that way.
Well, no, I'm not asking you to. I'm just saying.
It's just your personal style.
Well, because you know, I try as hard as I can to not have to think of the English response, but the issue then still becomes, like, I still have a lot of review to do for the past vocabulary and
so you don't necessarily
grammar structure
coming
that
up with...
I have forgotten that I didn't use enough, and so it now becomes me having to remember those instead of thinking of the ways that I might answer them.
Right.
Just, I guess, sort of like a more casual approach. And that's why when I default to thinking, how do I say this in English? Do I know how to say this in Japanese? That's
right.
Because I don't want to teach myself to do that.
Right. Yeah, you're trying to break that habit. One thing that helped me break that habit was just... When I was living in Japan, I decided to make it a habit to try to think about stuff in Japanese as much as possible. So if I was thinking about, you know, my agenda for that day, what I needed to do, whatever, I would try to think about it in Japanese. And when I got hung up on things I didn't actually know how to say, I would kind of add that to my mental list of things I wanted to look up and learn how to say for myself. But I was also in a pretty much immersion environment at that point, so it was easy to keep myself in Japanese mode all day long because I didn't keep getting jarred out of it by situations where I had to switch to English. Living here, I find that even as fluent as I am, I cannot keep myself in Japanese mode for very long because I keep getting interrupted by people who need me to speak to them in English. You know, I can't just function in Japanese all day. My kids are like, I don't understand what you just said, you know? But I understand your frustration with it.
Of it is because I don't really, like, I would consider myself to be, admittedly, socially awkward, so it's kind of hard for me to verbalize the things that I want to say.
Right.
In the same way that I would consider to be standard for other people.
Right.
So, you know, along with work, where, you know, when I'm working and I have to talk to people on the same level as them, I have to drop a lot of maybe the vocabulary and tendencies of speech patterns that I might have otherwise.
Right. So you have to conform to a standard that's not natural for you because you don't want to upset people.
Yeah, because for the longest time in school, I spent so much time getting good at writing essays and stuff like that, so I have a very, I don't really have, like, a middle ground. I have casual, like, when I'm out with my friends or when I'm Skyping them or something, and we just talk about
whatever, and it's extremely lax, and it makes sometimes makes absolutely no sense even in English, and it's just like, but and that kind of like, you know, because I don't have that like normal conversation middle ground that I really prefer to use, if that's why, like, you know, if I default thinking, what would I say that about this in English, it doesn't work, you know, because half of the expressions that I would use in English don't go translate over well into the Japanese, and
right.
vice versa, so.
Yeah, so if you can, that's one reason to try to come up with answers for these questions. Let me grab my stuff so I can go to the other building. Hold on. If you come up with answers.
Is there a sendoff in here or something else?
I left them here on purpose so that I could remember to share them with all my classes. Do you want one?
I know about it.
You know about it. Okay. It's also on the website. There's the college. great. Forgot to turn this off.